So we get a lot of queries regarding asthma. So what is asthma? How to prevent asthma attacks? So what are the different modalities of treatment? Is there anything else available apart from the inhalers? So let's go through the topics and answer these questions one by one. So asthma is a chronic inflammatory disorder of the airways. So in airways of the human beings, basically we have two lungs and we have a breathing tube called as the trachea here, which divides into bronchi and subsequently divides into multiple segments and opens up in air sacs called as alveoli inside the lungs. And the gas exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide takes place in the alveoli. So this is how the respiratory system works. In patients with bronchial asthma, these breathing tubes are lined with a mucosal layer. And the mucosal layer inside these breathing tubes is subsequently surrounded by a smooth muscle layer. In patients with bronchial asthma, there is a hypersensitivity of these mucosal layer as well as the smooth muscle layer. For example, somebody with bronchial asthma is exposed to dust and smoke, the mucosa would swell up and the smooth muscle surrounding this mucosa would go into a spasm. So what happens is the breathing tubes becomes narrower subsequent to the exposure to this dust, smoke or allergens, which we put together as triggers. So there is a bronchospasm along with there is a mucosal edema. So this summarily leads to the obstruction in the breathing tube called as bronchospasm or bronchoconstriction, which causes patients to cough, develop a sound, wheezing sound in the chest, become breathless and more symptomatic. So this is how an asthma attack happens. The most important thing here in asthma is to understand as to what worsens your asthma and identify these asthma triggers and prevent them as much as possible. So prevention is very, very important. The second thing is, if you are having persistent symptoms, then you need to be on certain medications called as inhaler medications, which will control your symptoms for prolonged durations. In spite of these controller medication, if you develop intermittent attacks, then you may have to take higher doses of these inhaler medications or add another inhaler for the initial inhaler. So despite this adequate medical management in the form of inhalers therapy, if you continue to have symptoms, then we have to explore if there is anything else which is responsible for your symptoms, and we have to do certain blood tests for eosinophils, immunoglobulin levels, etc., and we may have to do a CT scan of the lungs to see if there is anything else we are missing. And if identified as any another diagnosis apart from asthma, then the treatment will go on as per the diagnosis. If not, then the asthma will be diagnosed as something called a severe asthma, which is not responding to the usual treatment and continues to be uncontrolled despite optimal medical management. So in such patients, depending upon the type of the phenotype of the asthma, whether it's an eosinophilic asthma, allergic asthma, etc., then different modalities of treatment are available. Now we have newer molecules called as omalizumab, mepolizumab, etc., which can be used in patients who have elevated levels of immunoglobulins or eosinophils in their blood or the sputum. Then another new modality which is available for us is called as bronchial thermoplasty, which is a bronchoscopic procedure in which we pass a small catheter through the bronchoscope, through the mouth. It goes into the periphery of the lungs, where I was mentioning about the bronchial tubes becoming thicker. So this catheter of bronchial thermoplasty helps in reducing the bulk of the smooth muscles in the wall of the bronchi. So ultimately it opens up the airways and the patient will be able to breathe much better. So these have been shown to reduce the symptoms in these patients, prevent the repeated attacks of bronchial asthma, repeated hospitalization, the need for steroid therapy have all come down significantly, and this has definitely helped the patient a lot in this group of asthma called as severe asthma.